welcome to our YouTube channel. I really want to show you guys how to achieve this kind of painterly look and to kind of go through the scenes. I especially want to talk about the 3D models and the compositor in order to achieve the look that you just saw. When it comes to my 3D models, there's basically two things I want to talk about. I can do another in-depth video on the model itself later, but in order to achieve kind of the look that I had in the video, I first of all keep my models pretty simple. It's kind of low poly modeling still. However, I add usually a displacement modifier on it and with a cloud texture, just in order to break up the straight lines just a little bit and get it more stylized and fun looking. And the second thing that I usually do, or that I always do, especially for the style, is I hand paint all my models. And how I do that is basically I'm using this free add-on that is not sponsored, but I just really enjoy it. It's called Auto UV. It's from Blender Market, and it basically unwraps the models pretty good, at least for what I need. And then I usually start with a base texture, let's say like the washing machine is gray. In order to achieve that kind of like painterly look, I usually grab a few different grays and just brush up on there. I actually use a customized brush. We could talk about that later as well, but I just use a bunch of different colors and different values and stuff like that to brush them on and mix them all in order to kind of get this painterly look. And then when I'm happy with it, get a very small brush and paint some scribbles and black edges and stuff like that on it. I know I could also use grease pencil, but I just haven't done that yet. And now we're going a little bit more in depth. It's not going to be too complicated, but I just want to show a little bit of my workflow when it comes to the compositor. So just do it once, but basically right here I just rendered my image really quick, and then I usually start off with the Kuwabara filter, or my bad if I mispronounce it, but that's how I pronounce it. I usually have it set on a size of 3.5, and then next I put all my nodes in groups. That's basically what you see right here. But basically from the Kuwabara filter, I go right into the mix node right there, and right to the middle point right there for image. Then I mix the same image with a glare node in order to get some glare going. I talk about later what this will do. And then in the factor, I basically mix a dotted image texture that I found online, mix that with a translate node, an inverted color node, and a scale. You can see the my settings here, but basically for the scale I have it set usually on 0.2. That will give me the good size for the color dots that show up in the highlights. But if you see, I can change it to 0.1, then it's getting smaller, and if I change it to 0.5, it gets a lot bigger. And it's basically up to you what you like, but I like them at 0.2. And then when we play around with the threshold of the glare node, that will basically just increase the areas that will be highlighted more, which results in more dots in the image. But for me, 0.8 is good for the threshold. Sometimes I lower it a little bit, but that's totally up to you. And basically, so when everything is mixed now in this mix node, it continues to the next group that I made. And then we also have the mist pass. And that mist pass is important now. So you want to go to layer view, and then you can enable and disable the mist pass. And then basically, we'll use the mist factor as a factor in order to split the colors. So you can see here, if you go to your rendered view, live view, and then you click on mist, and then you go to the world settings, you can kind of define what is the foreground, what is the background, and according to that, it will split colors. But basically from the mix node, from the highlights, you want to go straight to another mix node, That's basically what I have. And remember, the upper one is kind of like the mix note from the render, and the lower one is the mist pass. But basically, you go have that mix note right into this mix note in order to combine the next thing, and then also the mist pass as a factor into this mix note. So we have our red, green and blue channels with a separate color note and a combined color note. And between red and blue, we basically put a displace note in order to split the red and blue channel. And then we control that actually with the X scale with another add note. And whenever we change a value in the add note, it will affect both X scale. So now if we change the value number on our add note, then to 10, it will split the colors more, and to 1, it will just combine it more. So I have my factor usually set to 5. And once this is done, this is all combined in that mix note that we talked about before, we go straight out to a lens distortion. We just put a 0.02 value in there, and that's basically it. So yeah, thank you for watching. Give me some feedback. This is my first tutorial. Let me know in the comments what you like, what you don't like. Follow us for more. We have a bunch of more stuff planned, including an animated series that we are currently working on. Give us a like. It would help us out to get this YouTube channel started and bring you more content.